So synchronized, for those who have learned database management or operating systems, this will be very easy. What is synchronized? Let me take an account object. Say I have an account class having all these fields, account number, holder and balance. And I create an object for my account. Say that is object is Satish. Satish is the object. He is having all these values. Account number, account holder name, and he has some 10,000 rupees in his balance. So now, when you have an object, multiple threads can refer to the same object. Say for instance, I can have two transactions. Each transaction can be considered as a thread. Say this is thread one, this is thread two. And what these threads are going to do is, it's going to work on the same data item for the same object. So who is the object here? Satish, and he has got some specific. So two threads are going to work on the same object. So in that case, say thread one or transaction one starts first. So it reads balance. What is the balance? So transaction one will get 10,000 as the balance. Next it is trying to do balance is equal to balance minus 1,000. So here there are two steps. First it will subtract 1,000 from 10,000. Say it's doing balance minus 1,000, so what will be the balance? 9,000. So while it is performing these activities, the thread 2, which runs parallelly, it's also reading balance for the same object. So what balance is going to read? So it's going to read 10,000 because you know, it has not still updated balance is equal to 9,000. So there are two steps here. What are those steps? That is balance minus 1,000 and then updating balance. So when it is performing balance minus 1,000, this guy reads the balance as 10,000. So parallelly, this guy can also work on the same object, right? And now this guy comes and updates balance. What is updating balance to be? 9,000. While he is updating, finishing the update of the balance, this guy does balance is equal to balance minus 1,000. So from 10,000, he reduces 9,000. And then he updates balance. So what balance is finally updated? 9,000. But actually, what should be the scenario when these two transactions run serially, one after the other? What will be the final balance? 8,000, right? These issues happen when two transactions work in an interleaved fashion on the same data item for the same object. We all agree. So say we have a set of instructions here. These instructions are interleaved. The only problem is they work on the same data item for the same object. So one thread interferes with the another thread. That is called thread interference. There's another issue, memory inconsistence. What is memory inconsistence? Whatever update this thread is making to balance is not actually visible to this thread, right? He is actually changing it to 9,000, but this thread is not able to see that change. So that's why this update is happening. So that leads to memory inconsistence. One update is not visible to another transaction running parallelly. So these are the issues you will get. So when you consider these steps to be a block of code, say withdraw, what all things you do? Read balance, balance is equal to balance minus 1,000, update balance. Should transaction 2 access this block of code while transaction 1 is executing? That is the question. Is this clear? While withdrawal is happening for Satish account, transaction 2 should not be allowed to again withdraw. These two things should not run parallelly. If it runs parallelly, what all things you will get? Interference, the issue that we have told you. And then memory inconsistence, that is memory consistency errors, that is one update is not visible to another. Let's check whether we are getting inconsistent results or not. You have an account class, create an object for that account class, and then you have two threads accessing the same withdraw method in that account class for the same object. And then what you do, you try to finally print the balance that is there. Very simple piece of code. Let me try that as fast as I can. Class account, and then we'll have balance to be the we'll forget the account holder name and some account number, right? For simplicity, we'll have only the balance. Next, what all methods you are going to have? You can create and you can have a constructor for your account, right? So whenever the account is getting created, we can put a balance here. So int deposit, something like that. So you can have this this dot balance is equal to deposit. Says initial deposit he makes while he creates the account. Next, what we'll have is we'll have this withdraw method. So we have to close this class. So what is this withdraw method? It's a public method. We'll have a very simple method, public void withdraw. And what we are going to get here, withdraw amount we are going to get. So, and what withdraw does, this dot balance is equal to this dot balance minus withdraw amount. So whatever amount we want to withdraw, we are just going to subtract it. We are not worried about the checks. is he withdrawing more than the available balance of those things? You can make those checks. So we have created this simple class account with a simple method called withdraw. Now, what we'll do is we'll create an object of type account. So we'll create an object of type account. It's new, create an object account, and say Satish is the holder for the account. And initially he has only 2000 rupees in his account. Okay. So you created the object. Next thing what we are going to do is we are going to have two threads created that will be parallelly withdrawing from, let's have 20,000. Why 2000 is very less? Because you are going to do a series of withdrawals now. Okay, now what we'll do is we'll create a thread. How will you create a thread? Thread thr1 is equal to new thread. And then you have to pass, we'll use the runnable object here. And then inside the run method, what I'm going to do, I'm going to withdraw a series of withdrawals I'm going to try. Int I is equal to 0, I less than 50, I plus plus. I'm going to call satish.withdraw, and then I'm going to withdraw say 100 rupees 50 times. So one thread will withdraw 5000 rupees. We'll have another thread parallelly working on the same account withdrawing 5000 rupees. So how will you create another thread? Quick, be quick with your thread creations. Create a new thread, and then what you do, you have this new runnable, and then you put again a series of withdrawals in parallelly. Parallelly, both of them are accessing the withdraw. So we'll just run some for int I is equal to 0, I less than, again he is making 50 withdrawals, each of amount satish.withdraw, we'll again withdraw 100 rupees. So this withdraws how much? 5000. This withdraws 5000. Everything happening parallelly accessing the withdraw method. Finally, we'll also print the balance. How will you print the balance? We'll start these two threads. Oh God, this is. We'll start these two threads. That is thr1.start and then thr2.start. Finally, we have to print whatever balance remaining in our account after these two withdrawals happen. So what will be that? So we'll do a sysout. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. Satish.balance. See, the problem is the final balance should be printed only after these two withdrawals complete. So somewhere you have to wait for thr1.join, and both these threads should complete so that we can print the final balance, or else some inconsistent results will be printed. Okay. So now let us run this. 10,000 withdraw, we have withdrawn 10,000 from 20,000. So what should be the final balance? So it gives 10,000. We have to run it several times to check whether there are certain inconsistencies happening. See, every time it runs, it somehow manages the right results. But when I was running it again, now it says balance is 10,700. We have withdrawn 10,000. How can it be 10,700? Somewhere that interference and memory consistent errors have cropped up. Anyway, so you are now convinced of the inconsistency, right?